they teach us to draw by starting with very, very simple shapes, because they're all these characters are very, very hard to draw. So Clawhauser, let's see. In a way, I haven't drawn him very much, but why don't we do this? Let's draw a big shape like this, because he's kind of a big blobby guy. Just do like a big squiggly line like this. It kind of goes up and down like that. That'll be a starting place for Clawhauser, so it can be roughly this. It doesn't have to be exactly that. Okay. All right. So we're going to put two eyes in this blob, and they're going to go right up here. See?
Okay.
So there's one eye there. One eye.
I'm changing pages.
Another eye.
No.
Oh, really?
Okay. Stick with it.
I don't have an eraser.
That's okay. Just
that's funny.
Just go over and over the shape.
Yeah.
There you go.
So put two little eyes up there, two big googly eyes. And then the characters in Zootopia usually look better if you do them a little more cross-eyed. So put one little pupil right there. And a little cross-eyed. Another one right there. There you go. See, it's all working out. See what's happening?
It's not bad.
It's Disney magic, okay. Right? Okay. A little line right into the eyes. That's not the mouth. What is that? That's the nose. That's right. It's the top of the nose. There it is. Okay, now you're halfway there. You're almost done. Ready? All right, now we're going to move down, and we're going to draw one more line under that.
Oh, mine is
there
awesome.
There you go.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
So a nice curvy line. Glenn Keane, the guy who drew Little Mermaid and the Beast, always taught me to put these little dark spots in the corners of the mouth. It's a little tuck. That's all he ever taught me. And he's a kitty cat, so you can put these little dots if you want here. There you go, little dots.
The cat dots.
Cat dots.
Cat muzzle dots.
Little whiskers. You throw some whiskers off there.
That says
cat.
These cute little ears. They're a little smaller than the eyes. There you go. We're going to stick them right up there. Good. All right. You can put eyebrows on them if you want. You want to do that? Eyebrows there. We're more daring. Nice. And then, now here's where it can just be free. Now you're going to put like spots. There you go. All over it.
Which side is his Mickey spot?
That is a perfect question. It's on his screen left side. It's right actually here.
Okay.
So if you do this, and your family will be so proud of you, there's a big Mickey.
Side note, I adore that the Mickey spot is on all the little sumsums.
And if you really want, just for a change, if you like to close a smile, you can keep that.
Oh,
but you can also draw a big old wide open mouth like this.
I'm writing too. Because I have a really big head.
You got a big head.
Keep the closed mouth, do you like?
Yeah, what do you think, Clark?
You think, Clark?
Yeah.
And then, what does he love?
Oh, look.
That's not bad.
You guys are blowing me away.
Is it good? They're all good.
Amazing.
They're all really good.
I am so impressed.
So he's drawing a donut, and I find hands hard to draw, so I usually just scribble. So it looks like art, right?
Yeah.
No one can judge you if you scribble.
Oh my goodness, okay.
No judges.
The donut.
And then you can see.
Oh, these are going online.
And then you can write something funny.
I love carbs.
Now I'm going to walk around and see.
That's a new Pixar movie, Carbs.
Those are awesome!
Is that
it? Oh, that's wicked.
And you add a layer under your drawing.
With worms. Oh, we don't have a worm. That is so not fair.
That's fair.
Not fair.
All right, anyway. I'm proud of you all. That's great. So good.
Rigged.
That's great. I'm going to look.
All right, guys.
Oh, that's
really
good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's really good.
Oh, those are good.
That's awesome.
That wasn't as bad as I thought
see?
It would be.
Yeah, let's see.
Right.
I can animate.
Yay.
Sort of.
Nice.
Sort of.
That's
so cute.
Let's see that.
That's great.
Those are awesome.
Like I was
wow.